Oh boy, what do I have to start for this rant? I don't even know. Hello everyone, all good morning everyone. This is your good old neighbor, Nikki Confused into a dog, and welcome to the Nutto Today's videos. And this is the kind of rant I really want to get started by chat because I was planning to going to do this rant last year, but I didn't get the time because I was so focusing for my Christmas review week and Halloween review week and etc. Anyway, people, I really hope you enjoyed my movie review of Goosebumps because even that movie was, sorry, I'm saturating again. Back on saying, sorry guys, even the Goosebumps back in 2015 is a really great movie, but the story is really confusing, and some of the characters is really annoying, and the CGI of the monster is completely works pretty bad for Sony Picture Animation live action. Anyway, guys, so today I am doing a rant on the Marvel movie Critic. And no, people, I'm not trying to bash your opinion. I'm not trying to be an opinion basher, which honestly, I'm just getting sick and tired of bad movies getting great review and fantastic movie like Amsterdam and Blonde, which I'm going to see it on tonight on my phone on Netflix. I don't care if it's NC-17, but I love to watch that kind of stuff. And no, that didn't mean I would do stuff from NC-17. That's kind of stupid. Like, seriously? Rated R with NC-17 trying to brainwash me? That has got to be one of the most, honestly, that has got to be the most ridiculous reason I ever heard by a human. Anyway. Anyway, guys, so enjoy this rant. It's going to be a huge drama for a movie critic and the audience. Anyway, some of your movie critic audience out there are watching this video. You gotta stop. Honestly, you gotta stop with this nonsense. Because honestly, I'm getting sick and tired of bad movies getting great review, which honestly, which is the movie got great review? I crap you not. It was Ariel Crocodile, which just came out the same day of Amsterdam, and now DCC the Super Pack got great review also. And the Rotten rating, I probably you're not gonna be happy about this because those two movies got one. It's had to be a movie called Amsterdam, which honestly I watched it last night. It was honestly that movie was a brilliant masterpiece, and I really like it. Honestly, it's a art of film, anyway. And the movie, which I'm going to watch tonight on my phone on Netflix, it's had to be Blonde. The main reason why I don't want to watch it on my television because I don't need no NC-17 shows on my TV. So, no NC-17 on my TV. So, that's my rule. Anyway, honestly, I would be cool that is rated R or PG-13 or PG on my TV, but not NC-17 on my TV because I don't need that kind of my stuff on my TV, but on my phone. Anyway. Anyway, guys, so now let's talk about some. Honestly, let's get the rotten rater. We're going to get to the great one. The tomatoes. Anyway. Anyway, guys, now let's talk about the tomatoes of the fresh, the tomato score. Anyway. Anyway, guys, those two films have some really great review. It had to be Ariel Crocodile, which I did not believe why people like that piece of crap. And which is the worst movie of the year. It has to be the DC Lead of a Super Pet. Yeah, that movie, I hate to say, but that movie is even worse than that Space Jam, A New Legacy, and Scoop. Honestly, I think DC Lead of a Super Pet, that has got to be one of the worst one animation group I have ever seen. And honestly, I am completely done with one animation group because I keep giving them the super chance like the Reagan and Jaga movie, Scoop, and Space Jam and New Legacy, and Tom and Jerry the movie, which is Tom and Jerry movie is a less bad for one animation group. But after I seen DC, the Super Pet, yeah, that movie, yeah, I was completely done with one animation group because it was not good it used to be. But anyway, that movie got a good rating, which honestly, it did not deserve like a good rating. That movie deserved like a 0% of Rotten Tomatoes because that movie was bad. And sorry guys, here's the movie which just came out the exact same day of Amsterdam. It's had to be LL Crocodile, which I was really wish that this movie will get a Raspberry, honestly, will get a Rotten rating and let Amsterdam be a tomato rating. But ain't wrong. LL Crocodile got good reviews. A lot of people love it. A lot of people call it one of the best family film of the year. Which honestly, I don't understand why people keep doing that same old bullcrap. Because it's really like scene 2 all over again. Praising. Because at the audience score, honestly, I crap you not. The audience score is literally like a 94% on for the audience. Honestly, I don't understand my audience like that kind of movie, because that is not my kind of movie I'll watch in a theater, because I was planning to go and see that movie in theaters with my mother, which honestly, I was saying to myself, you know what, there was no way in the monkey I will waste my hard money for Black Adam to see LL Crocodile. I'm not gonna skip Black Adam. I would see Black Adam better than with watching LL Crocodile. No, excuse me, I will be in a screening of Black Adam. Which that movie got good reviews. I am afraid that, honestly, I do not trust Rotten Tomato at all. Anyway, guys, now let's get to the Rotten rating. Oh, boy. What do I have to start about you, Rotten rating? Honestly, this year, Rotten Tomato, this has got to be one of the worst years for Rotten Tomato. Honestly, I think it's even worse than scene 2 got great reviews, and some of the great movie got bad reviews, which is, I don't want to talk about it. Anyway, The Witch, the movie got a rotten rating. Let me rewind back on the beginning of the year. Anyway, the beginning of a rotten rating, the movie got a rotten rating, which is other than Deep Water, Fantastic Beasts 3, Jurassic World Dominions, Don't Worry Darling, and the two movies, which I'm talking about in this video, and honestly, if you've seen the pictures, the two movies I'm going to talk about today is Amsterdam, which I watched last night, and Blonde, starting Anna de Montmorency, the movie of, and Blonde, which is the movie about the storytelling of how Mary Malone was really dying, that one, anyway. Anyway, guys, now let's get to Amsterdam first, because I was really hope that, I really hope that movie will be LL Crocodile with the rotten rating. Honestly, do you realize LL Crocodile will get a rotten rating? Nope. Amsterdam got a rotten rating. Wah, wah, wah. Yup. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. The very first David O. Huster movie got very nasty review. Nobody liked it. Nobody want a movie called Amsterdam, which honestly, I feel bad for that movie. Didn't get any good reviews because David O. Huster is really a bad guy. Didn't mean his movie is bad. Honestly, The Joy 2015, that movie looks bad because that movie looks boring. Which honestly, I'm not gonna watch Saving the Living Playbook. Which honestly, that movie looks overrated. That has got to be one of the most overrated movie of 2012. Anyway, I just watched it for myself last night, and honestly, I do not get the hate for this film. Anyway, and the box office numbers. Honestly, the box office numbers of Amsterdam is completely disaster. It's completely disaster. This movie flop, and now this movie is not going to get this kind of movies. Honestly, this is going to be the end of David O. Huster movies. And now a lot of people is going to put this movie as the worst movie of the year. And speak of that, and honestly, do you honestly think Amsterdam is the only rotten rating? Well, you're wrong. Because there's a one movie which I'm going to watch it tonight after dinner on my phone. It's had to be the movie called Blonde, starring Anna de Montmorency, which honestly, that movie, the hate of this movie is completely uncalled for. People need to stop hating the film just because it's NC-17. And who in the right mind that you human being think Bond, which is a true story of Marilyn Monroe, is way worse than that disgusting movie called Cuties? Don't want to talk about it. Don't want to show a picture of it. Don't want to get you disgusted. Anyway, yeah, I was really hope that Blonde will get a Oscar review. Which honestly, I am afraid that this movie will get a Razzie Award. The same thing with Amsterdam, because those two films do not deserve like a rotten rating. Honestly, they deserve like a good rating. Honestly, if I am a CEO for Rotten Tomatoes, I will make Rotten Tomato a really good, like seriously, I'm getting sick and tired of these days movie critic all liking bad movies and hating on great movies. Honestly, it's kind of feel like this world is upside down. This world is upside down. The same thing with the music genre. People like bad music and people hate good music. The same thing with the movie. People like bad movies and people hate good movies. People, that's not how you do it. That's not how you do a movie credit. Honestly, let's turn the world back to normal and now this world is upside down. Which I did not like it, and I did not like this today's society. So stay tuned for my Why My Generation Sucks video. It's going to be a 6-part rant because honestly, I have a lot to say about these generation because the generation is not good, honestly. It's just not good. My America need to get themselves together, and the movie credit, you need to get themselves together because it's the main reason why the frozen community are getting angry at you because you keep getting good review a wanting rating and you keep getting bad movie a fresh rating. And don't worry, Work movie got a rotten rating, but thank God for that because I was afraid that that movie will get a good review. But honestly, back in the movie BD, which is a website I use it for my thumbnail, which that movie got a good review, which honestly, I don't understand why some people, you know what, I'm done. Sorry guys, overall, movie credit, back in 2023, which is next year, people, you need to get some stuff together. You need to stop taking great movie way to an extreme. You need to stop praising bad movie right though better than God, which honestly I'm getting sick of tired of saying, ooh, the bad movie is better than God, and the great movie is real, the evil wasn't the devil. I'm done. Movie credit, get yourself together, and stop taking Bond way too seriously. I'm gonna watch it with my open mind. I don't care if it's NC-17, because honestly, hating the film because it's NC-17, it's kind of remind me that I hate Showgirl just because it's NC-17. That is a different story. That movie should not exist in the first place because Toy Story is a much better 1995 movie than Showgirl. So you know what? I'm done. Sorry, guys. If you like, if you like this type of rant, I highly recommend you hit the subscribe button, turn the notification, and share the video for all fans for ages. So, you guys, if I give it time to watch Blonde, which honestly, I don't have time right now. Maybe after lunch or dinner time. Anyway, guys, so tomorrow morning, I'm going to watch How Will We End. So stay tuned for my movie review of How Will We End tomorrow. And stay tuned for my movie review of Blonde rated on tonight. Anyway, guys. This is Naked2001 signing out for now. Alright guys, I see you next time. And so on can peachy tooth. Have a good day, everyone. And movie critic, get yourself together. And honestly, I'm not trying to bash your opinion, but honestly, just use your common sense. You got a brain to use it. Have a good day, everyone. And I see you guys later.